who got off the mark with a 78-59 victory against another of the strugglers, the Bakken Bears, last week. That's our matchup here in Nahariya on game day 5. And the home side and their fans would love to see them on home court finally get a win. Talk about how they got into this competition, because they weren't one of the originals 40 teams, of course, in the Basketball Champions League this year, and they've made it through by not the most straightforward route. Fans starting to come into their seats, and hope springs eternal for them, and indeed for the home side, who led for much of the game in Monaco in week 4. Yancey Gates, and we'll see him in a few moments' time, having an absolute stormer with 23. Sadly, he and several of the other players on the team ran out of gas. They ultimately ran out of a lot of steam, going down 71-64, allowing the French side to score 29 in the final quarter. These are the fixtures taking place in Group A. See, we're underway same time as two of the other games. Bakken Bears, Fraport Skyliners, and Chez Nimberg and Aris already underway. Available on the website. We'll see, it's fairly well advanced. Is the 6 o'clock Central European time game in Banvit. And that is the table as it stands. You can see it's only a matter of points differential that's keeping the Israeli team off the bottom. Two teams without a win, one of whom we're seeing here today. And Bakken Bears, beaten by Helios Suns last weekend, are the other. Suns, by virtue of that win in Dobrošale last week, off the bottom by two places. Tomáš Kyslík scoring 21 in their 19-point triumph over the Bakken Bears. So things look a little bit more encouraging for them. It's taken a while for them to get going in the competition so far. They had a 62-54 reverse against Aris in their opening game. Went down by just 4 against Monaco. Very good performance. There's their lineup today. You see the Americans quite prominent. And two players who played together in America at Harvard, wearing 10 and 30. Brandon Curry and Carl Casey. They'll be very influential in this team if they can turn it around and get a second win in the competition. Home side had to get through the hard way, had to qualify, and they did it very well by winning both of their qualification games. And there is their lineup. I mentioned Yancey Gates, what a week he had last week, very nearly getting them over the line. First three quarters looked brilliant, but didn't get the support he wanted in quarter 4, and they rather fell away at the end, allowing the to score 23 in that last quarter and turn the whole game around. Mentioning the Nahariya team, as the Helios Suns are introduced to the crowd, played Smoky Minsk the early part of October. Two games in the space of 3 days, quite testing, and won the first 70-66. Got the second win by the same margin, almost the same score actually, 71-67 on that occasion. Well, I wonder what that win last week will have done for that team. Helios Suns had to wait till week 4 to get their win, but they're off the mark and off the bottom of the table as well. The crowd here will be hoping they can see their team at long last get a win, because it has been since the beginning of October since they've last registered a victory on this court in this competition. Hoping that their Americans can step up. Of course, they have played, as we mentioned, 2 more games than everybody else, so they should be in the groove by now, you would think. Certainly get to know each other very well. Quite a few of these players have signed 1-year contracts here, so they are playing for their spots already for next season. And they won't want to lose today, because in effect, the win for Helios today, me and the Israelis, mathematically, are pretty much out of any kind of progression. April seems a long way off, but second round seems a long way off at the moment for them. Looking for their big men to step up to the plate today. We'll see the officials in a moment's time. They come from Spain, from Albania, and from Italy. So see the respective coaches here, our officials. Vicente Bulto of Spain, Gentian Sisi of Albania, and Tolga Sahin of Italy. They'll be the men in charge of this game in Nahiriya, which is one of those touristy locations in Israel, northern part of the country. A place that a lot of Israelis tend to go, where a lot of foreigners will go to Tel Aviv and places like that. The people who live in Israel go to Nahiriya for their breaks in the summer. Quite that kind of weather at the moment, I'm afraid. It's a bit chilly, to say the least, as you might expect, at the heart of November. Now, will the cockles of the home side's fans be warmed here? They certainly could do with it. And they've got players who can do it. And there's a starting five for the away team today. A couple of their American imports in there. Brandon Curry and Carl Casey. I mentioned both of them playing together at Harvard. Well, they're playing together on the starting five for the Helios Suns. Was Kishlink going for 50 points plus tonight. 49 he's on at the moment. There's Jasko Vulic, head coach of the Slovenian team. Looking dapper. And the home team have a coach, Eric Alfassi, who will get very demonstrative. I mean, coaches tend to anyway, don't they? But he's a man who does wear his heart on his sleeve, and I think we'll pretty hear. Both the coaches are mic'd up here. You'll pretty hear him fairly loud during the course of this game. There's their starting five, and they have gone with the top scorer in the competition, not surprisingly, number 83. It's Claude Brand. He'll be in the starting lineup with 51 points already in the competition over six games. There's Eric Calfassi on, that's on the left, he's now on the right. Four Americans on the Israeli team, we'll probably see a great deal of, certainly Derwin Kitchen we mentioned, Yancy Gates, 74 points already registered in the competition in six games, remember, with those extra two they played at the beginning of the campaign. But, America's all kind of around about 26, 27 years of age, including Stuart Douglas. Looking for back-to-back victories for the first time in the campaign. Helios Suns, a win of any description would be good for the team in white. We're ready. Hope you're ready for week number five of the Basketball Champions League. competition three taking shape. This one we have two unbeaten teams at the top of the table and two teams looking for wins at the bottom. Just a bit of a chasm now starting to open up on the first tip of the game as we're underway. And for new tuners on, Elios Suns in the blue playing from right to left in this first quarter. Rimakun will bounce pass under the hoop, helped back in on the second attempt by Matic Vesel. And Helios Suns take the early lead. First offense, first two. Derwin Kitchen will be looking fine. His man at the low post. He does. It'll be a two and one. He gets fouled in the act of shooting. Tyrone Nash goes to the hoop, draws the foul. Foul will be on Corey Remakun. And he'll go to the line for the bonus. Good start for Homicide, just to get themselves into the groove. SL. KC, throw it away. It's the fairly unmistakable sight of the Aroni number 83. So he's the man with the most accumulated points so far from the last few games. Hilton Skjoldebrand. Well, shot clock's down to zero. Took a long, long time. It's like he was sleepwalking through that. Look at the clock going down. And the coaches get really annoyed about that. Not even any attempts to get into field goal range or even three-point range there. So that's an unnecessary turnover. Brown. Sassi Asari. Nice drive. Nice bucket. Nice two. Simply done by Skjoldebrand. And home side in front for the second time in the game. Remakun. And there's a foul under the hoop. Foul will be called Skjoldebrand. There is the other end. There he is picking up the foul. So 2 points followed immediately by a foul. In by Casey. Looking for a way inside. You have to go outside. Everything's happening from a long way out from the basket right now. It's going to have to drive and find a way. It's very tight on that right-hand side of the court. In and out. Right on the 24-second shot clock. No worries, because it did hit the ring, come back out again. Arunasanti Asari. There's the steal. There's a turnover. That should be 3 points for Thomas Kischlink. Derwin Kitchen. For an option maybe here. A little crossover. Bounce pass inside. No way to the hoop from there, but just a bit too close there, Casey, for the official's liking. Touch team was just trying to spin move into the hoop. And that's the two at the other end from Kischlink. 4 points apiece. Nearly double teamed there, so there was no way to escape that easily. Kitchen. Looking for the jumper, puts it back out for the three-pointer. That attempt will go left, but will form back into the grateful hand of Nahariya player. In this case, Tyrone Nash. There's the foul. And there's another one for Remakun. That's his second of the game so far. Early stage, only had 2.5 minutes. And already that's two fouls against Remakun. Coach thinking about taking him out. Coach does take him out. Two fouls very early on. Second reset on the shot clock. Busy little bee's kitchen at the moment, and there's a foul just happening off the play, and that's the second one. That's a foul for Skjoldebrand. What's a bit of movement? What's a bit more impetus here? Because they're very slow, quite ponderous in terms of their build up. For a way inside, there is a way, got into the paint, but gonna have to do a lot of hard work by himself. And that was just a kind of a bit of a throwaway by Bolsena there. Field goal was at a premium for them, and that was again being thrown away. No quality shots as Bolsena into the action and making things happen. They need somebody with a little bit more guile, perhaps. Casey should be the man. Kischlink looks up. They're going to try and rotate it back to him, or maybe they're going to go baseline, and they do for two. And Carl Casey it is, who puts the away team in front by two. And your Suns have a two-point advantage. Doesn't look like it's going to be a very high-scoring first quarter, the way things are shaping up here. Skjoldebrand. Just waiting there and trying to take a couple of men with him. They'll wait for the pass, come back out to him for the three. Second three-point attempt does not land where it wants to. Oh, and Casey's not sure about that call. It's going to be a foul, though, on the number 30. Threw his man off the scent. Gilbert Brown went flying. Quite a few accumulated fouls. It must be into the Iron Team fouls now. Takovic into the action for the first time. Tyrone Nash, Derwin Kitchen, Santi Asari. Little screen being shown there. Here comes the shot right on the 24 seconds and help back in. Somehow, some way, doesn't matter how they fall. It did fall for Jonten Skjoldebrand. And we are level at six apiece. No, oh, it's a good lane and a good opening, taken very gratefully by Tomáš Kischlink. Takes him into the 50s in terms of points this season for the Helios Suns. Santi Asari, that's nice work, nice play by Derwin Kitchen. Saw his opening, saw the opportunity, not very closely marked, and just wriggled his way through there without too much problem. Kischlink. Rotation a bit better from the away team, but the shot no good. Kitchen will accelerate and will get fouled. Foul on Brandon Curry. So that's team fouls. It will go to the line for two. Work by Derwin Kitchen, and there he is on the line for two. Here comes Nick Faust. So the two free throws finds its way in, and Naria have a lead. Oh, first one went in, second one did not, and quickly was trying to get there for the rebound. Skjoldebrand couldn't. Anyway, into the paint. No, two men guarding him very well, and that hook shot was never going to find its target from Bolsena. Faust pops back out. We haven't seen a three-point yet. Seen loads of attempts, but none scored. And that will be Maria Ball with 14 seconds now on the reset on the shot clock. Well, they won two of the quarters last week, but weren't able to capitalise. Be good for them to get on the scoreboard in front at the end of 10 minutes play here. Going to go for the three-pointer. Another one comes in and goes back out again. Asante Asari, but of course the reset to 14, so got a bit of time to reset this play. Finding a way through. Oh, that's lovely! Nick Faust hardly been on the court in any effective means so far until now. That's brilliant. Really bulldozed his way through. And a lovely little shot. Fade there to get that in for two. Brandon Curry up for no points at the other end. That was going to be a surefire two. Look at this. Lovely. Oop, 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 oop. Nice stuff. Love it. Eight. 3:25 remaining first quarter. Kitchen and Faust have got a good understanding already. Is there any way through there? No, there isn't, and that will be Naria Ball. And it might well be that the Helios Suns coach might want to have a chat pretty soon, because the game plan was already having. That's just the Naria coach, not the Helios Suns coach, but that's pass inside. Is there any way through? Oh no, stripped away. Well, it's kind of fell out of his hands more than anything else, and being stripped away. So we haven't seen a 3 point attempt. There's the foul on the Santi Asari. So on the back of his shirt, it's got Azra. I have a Santi Asari is his name, so play it which way you will. Brandon Curry now looking maybe for the three-point attempt to level things up here. So we haven't seen a three converted yet. Seen a few attempted, but that's thrown away poorly by Helios Suns, who haven't quite got into this game yet. Yep, here comes the timeout, which I didn't think was too far away from coming. And we'll get to hear from the coaches exactly how they think things are going here, with the home side leading by 11 points to 8. Those rebounds are quite staggering, aren't they? Looks like Helios Suns are hardly in the game, and to be fair, although they're only 3 points adrift, they're not for the most part. Rebounds, defensive and offensive, being won by Naharia. And here they come with that 3 point advantage with 2:42. See if they can make it count. I did say it probably wouldn't be a very high scoring first quarter. That's how it's turning out to be at the moment. Santi Asari. Yancy Gates gets the chance to see what he can do. And again, that's a good interception and a good rejection. It does go behind for Ironi Naria Ball. Gonna get it in as quickly as he can. Gates. Oh, it's a bit too much to expect the big man to launch that over about two or three players in his way. He wasn't quite able to do so. Sheena. You have to get to go out wide. Here comes a three-point attempt that might land, and does. First of the night on either side to find its target. And it's Brandon Curry. First season with the Suns. Enjoying that three-pointer, which puts his side level. And here comes a chance for the lead for no points. Just wanted to take a little bit too much of the showboating there. And fouls up for three to respond, and does. Well, he scored a spectacular two. And now he's responded to that three with a three of his own. He goes to five. Two for three on field goals. First attempt from three-point range finds his target. Three-point lead is restored as we head to the end of the first quarter. Curry through and gets fouled. That doesn't drop, so he'll go to the line for two. Faust is the man who will get the cross against his name, but look at that. What a rejection. He's doing everything. Both ends of the court. Faust at the moment. Dramatic two, the brilliant three, and then the rejection at that end. And 14-10 is how it looks with a minute and 20 to go in the first. Out goes Derwin Kitchen. So the lead is trimmed, and it's back to 2 points, 14-12. Into the action for Nauria comes Stuart Douglas. Perkovic, they're bringing the changes here on this offense, and Yancey Gates gets his two. First two of the night, 4 point lead, here it comes. Get a long way around. Just putting it back for the three-point attempt. Just thinking about the three, I think it's kind of a twist in between in terms of trying to decide exactly what was the best option there. Faust waiting for somebody to go to the basket. Instead, the two goes up. It'll be a and one. The Yancey Gates putting his second two back-to-back twos for the number four for the home side. And he'll get the extra bonus to come. Couldn't find any way through, first of all. Bolshina is annoyed by that. He's already picked up a cheap foul. It's another one. So, biggest lead of the game so far. Six for the home side. Soon it becomes seven if Gates can put this one down. Ooh, that was a very poor attempt. Struggled to actually make the hoop at all. Just clipped the outside of it, but nowhere close to going in. Last offense of the first 10 minutes play will belong to Elios. Now going to get shot away. Shot clock and game clock pretty similar here. Up it goes for two. Rebound will come back out. Have they got long enough to get the shot away? Not really. And that's a very impressive for the home side. First 10 minutes play. And their Suns really haven't got going here at all. 18-12, I think when we see all the boards will be very much in favour of Irone Nauria at the end of 10 minutes play. All the good things you'll see on the showreel for the most part, all coming from the men in white, and the men in blue and orange need to get going if they want back-to-back wins in this competition, because they're not at the races right now. The stats, free throws, two for two for Helios and only one for four for Nauria. That could be a very important figure at the end of the night. 3-point attempts, only 1 for 6. Nevis have only tried one so far.
Cover the line. Basket, basket. Offensively, next open. Shirt, two. With the two pick and roll. Pick and pop and continue. Open shot or continue over there. Emma, wake up. Play stronger, guys. Come on.
There you stand. Bounce with 5. We'll see two there, not from him, but from Nash. The Yancey Gates had an immediate impression coming into the game with back-to-back twos. Faust is a man that he wants to try and keep out there for as long as possible, I think. He's played in all the games so far, been very effectual in all of those games as well so far. Berkovits for Maria. Faust thinking this time, shows it left, shows it right. There she finds the man, Berkovits. There's the baseline then. This is away pretty quick because the shot clock's down to 2 and there's no obvious shot. The third, fourth, fifth attempt doesn't drop. 3 or 4 rebounds there, another which was obliging in terms of getting a decent shot away. And Gary has it back at the other end. Manage, haven't seen much of him in the first quarter, but he's into the action now. Spread the play, going central. Oh, stolen away again, this time by Berkovits. They're spending too much time on the ball, trying to decide exactly what to do. That's not going to drop either. But they're looking for the pretty picture postcard play, and it's just not quite working for them. Needs to be probably a little bit more direct. Lelic brought in for that very reason. Back out for Klinch, and then that's going to be a rebound for somebody. Rebound for somebody in white, and a quick, nearly a jam. Faust it is, getting himself into position A, as he has done so often in this game. He'll have a chance to go to the hoop, because he was fouled in the act of shooting. Just trying to jam it in there, but lands awkwardly, but I think he's going to be okay. So 18-12. That's now 1 for 5 on free throws. How much will that hurt the Israeli team down the stretch? And that one does just about oblige. 18-12. Lead back up to 6. Well, virtually unguarded there. Easily done. Berkovits. Gates. Taking their time. Faust has done everything pretty much pinpoint accurately in the game so far. And continues in that fashion again, by extending that lead to 7. Very good from the floor. 3 out of 4 so far. The lead is 7. Shovel pass, that's nice. That's really nice. Great interchange there. Superb play, the best we've seen by them by quite some way. And that's another 2 from Naria. We get a 9-point advantage. Oh, need double figure play for them here. Curry up for 2, which obligingly finds its way in. After thinking about going the other way, it did actually drop, so trims that lead. He goes to 6 personal, but at the moment they're being overrun and outgunned pretty much in every way. They're having a double team Gates, but not that effective. Gates still gets the shot away, and Naria in control of this game. And at the moment, Suns not looking like they're going to make much of a run, but we know they're capable of doing it, because they did it last week. In this game, they're being kept very quiet indeed. Just the 14 points in the opening 10 minutes. And all the rebounds have been falling away of the men in white up until now. But now it's a chance for the team in blue. And again, an easy bucket for Remakun, who was taken out of the game early on because he got two fouls in the opening few minutes. But back into the play. Game down to a 7-point lead. Remakun two from two from field goal range. That's where they want him. That's going to be the last touch coming off the home side's player. 6:16 remaining in the second quarter. The City Hall in Nairia, City Arena. And we're going to hear from the respective coaches of the time out was called, but no. Haven't seen that much of him so far, but there's two more to add to his tally, and two more to add to Helios, who moves to 20. He moves to 6. 3 out of 4 attempts on the floor, working their magic. Berkovits. Okay, there we go. Almost a long way around. There's a lot of blue shirts in the way, and so the quality shot wasn't really on, and they're going to get possession back with Remakun. Now, it's Vratic into the action. And we are now going to have that timeout I was talking about just now, so we'll hear what the coaches have to say. That lead down to 5 points, 25 to 20. So for the home side, 8 points for Faust, 8 points for Gates, and for the Helios Suns, 6 points for Kishlink, 6 points for Curry, and four each from Rimbakun and from Casey. They are the main contributors to a game that is still very tight, scrappy at times, but still mightily competitive. The home fans just think tonight might be their night. A bit too early to get too carried away yet, but they're certainly making it difficult for the Helios Suns. They're having to shoot from a bit further out than they would like, but that's relatively easy too. And suddenly on a bit of a run, Helios with that 6th point from Casey, 3 from 4 from the floor. Let's trim that lead to 3. This is where they get tight and they're not getting quality around the basket, and that will be a foul. Foul committed by Remakun, his third foul too early on. There's another one. You're on the other end. Two from far out, so here comes the two free throws. Now they've not been great from this range so far. 2 from 6, make that 3 from 7. Lead back up to 4. More like it from Tyrone Nash. And up to 5 we go. Yeah, 4 from 8 now. And the Ulster with only two opportunities so far, both of them converted. Nicely done. Kishlink with the two. Hasn't done too much wrong. 8 points, leading scorer for the away team at this stage. Just slowing things down, waiting for a couple of players to get into position and to get a very long bomb away, but that one doesn't find its target. And danger here, there's the foul. Foul committed by Gilbert Brown. And Helios Suns to the line to trim that lead. I say they're 2 from 2 from the line so far. Kivitz goes out to the line. Here's Dordi Lelic. First of two. Well, they trailed by 6 at the end of first quarter. There'll only be one behind if he can drain this. Doesn't drop though, so only 1 for 2 on that occasion. Derwin Kitchen then makes the charge into the corner to try and get that ball back again. Faust, that's pass inside, down to 5 on the shot clock for Yancey Gates. Dribbles in, dribbles out. Last touch, the officials consider came off of Remekun. Oh, hello. That's a version of the Israeli conga or something going on there, but here's Faust back out. 3, inside for 2, looking for a way through. He got the shot away. Now, was he fouled? He was fouled in the act of shooting, so it's going to be 3 from the line. Lelic got too close. Lelic jumped into him as he was in the act of shooting, so he'll go to the line for 3. And right on the buzzer. I think, I was checking that because Nick Faust to the line for 3, first one dribbles out. Yeah, a lot of head scratching certainly going on the Helios Sun side of things. There's another one gone. There's free throws, could just come back to horn them. 4 from 10. 5 from 11 now, so they've missed more than they scored. Faust goes to 9. Just checking the stats. Nash has hardly been off the court for them. Is it 14 minutes he's been out there? Something like that. Foul on the way to the hoop, committed by Stuart Douglas. 3:34, the second remaining. No way through there. Let it try and find a way. And take it round. Nice interchange. No. Travel is the call. Remekun and Lech trying something a bit special. Not that special because he took the extra step. Kitchen gets over halfway and then 8 seconds. Drive by Douglas, up for 2. And Laria, 5 in front. Register 30 points, 30-25. So no problems in the first 3 quarters last week. It was the last quarter that did fall, and they want a sizable lead. they can to try and protect later in the game. Good spin, good turn. That should be 2 milliseconds in the sector. But yeah, it was basically staying there and waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. Ravacoon gets penalised for that. That's a personal foul number four for Ravacoon. So too early, and then two more in this quarter means we may not see him for a while. They're trying to keep Kitchen as far away from the basket as they can, but it's finding a way to avoid that trap. They come back out to him as well, having a look and see whether he's got a sighter for a three. Goes for the two, works his way inside, all been him. And there's the rebound. Back out for three. And that's drained by Stuart Douglas. And Naria showing that they could be a force to be reckoned with today. Three-pointers have been at a premium on both sides. And that was popped nicely out before Douglas could get a hand in the face. He got that away. And the lead is now 8 points. Well, here will the coaches think about that with Naria on top.
Again, the penetration, and after that kick out, no fadeaway shot. They won't call that foul. We need some foul to push him in the bonus, and looking for a free throw. For a free throw. You are on position five. So. One option is four up for him. Second option is go with Simo. You got the option for a shot or continue with the handoff. They will switch with the Svejan is Gjoldebran and Nash. Be ready for that pass on the side and attack them.
Bounced up to 9 personal now for the home side. 8 from Gates, 5 from Douglas with that 3-pointer. And leading scorers for the away team are Kishlink with 8, and Curry with 6, and also Casey with 6. Points the differential between them. Taking their time, rushing on this. That one nicely drained by Casey. That'll bring the lead back to 6. Bit more urgency at the other end though. Pointing it out for another 3. That Douglas, yes it is. Another one finds its way in. And that is 2 from 2 from 3-point range for Stuart Douglas. 8 points in total. Those back-to-back threes are helping matters, and then the jam at the other end will trim that lead yet again. Carl Casey first to get into double figures for the away team. Derwin Kitchen again might have to do an awful lot by himself. Puts it back out for the 3-pointer, but it's just a little bit short. Elio Sons will try and advance this more quickly this time. Curry will go all the way to the hoop. 4-2. Beautifully done. That was speed and endeavour and inventiveness from the Helios Suns number 10. Just got round the first marker. Skjoldebrand. Before he could get challenged. Went for a little swing on the hoop.
We play soft on the pick and roll. We play soft. We are both used. Lockdown. One-on-one situation. You switch so easy. Don't switch. Play aggressive on the ball. And if we have fault to use, make the foul aggressive. Hey. Hey. We play 11 in defense. Okay? In offense,
Douglas with back-to-back threes, giving the home side just the impetus they needed to keep them away from the onrushing Helios Suns, who are trying to eat into that lead, just trying to edge themselves back into this game. To be honest, nowhere near the quality we saw from them a week ago, but they're not too far adrift, only 5 points adrift, and they'll put the press on. They're putting the full court press on this time, trying to stop Kitchen getting out. So Kitchen does manage to get away. Douglas is the man they've got to keep quiet, because he's been looking super sharp from three-point range. He's getting back into that arc again, but this time they go for the short two, and Yancey Gates adds to his tally. Gates goes into double figures, 10 from him. Last offense potentially for the away team of this first half coming up. Lelic, got to do something quickly though. It's only five on the shot clock. That's a way to nothing. Now a chance for the home team to get the last two. They take themselves into the 40s and halfway, and they look like they're going to do it as well. Just a bit short by Derwin Kitchen, but that has been a decent first 20 minutes for Nahariya. Took a while to get going last week, and then second and third quarters were great. They fell away in the fourth. What's the story going to be today? Story at halftime is 38-31. 10 points from Gates, 9 from Faust. The main contributors, 8-2 from Douglas, including those 2 3-pointers. And for the Helios Suns, Casey, only player in double figures with 10. Free throws, nothing to write home about for the home team. 3-pointers coming in a bit of a rush, 3 from 11. None so far for the Slovenians. Field goals they're winning on. That's about all they're winning on. Rebounds very much in favour of the home team, 22-14. Offensive rebounds definitely, and assists 11-5. So pretty much in all the stats that matter, Nahariya are leading. And these are the turnovers, 7-5. Helios steals 4-3. Bench points, look at that, 27-1. It tells you the starting five didn't quite do the business, but everybody else has since. And it will be because Faust has been absolutely outstanding tonight. Really has. It's been the difference. It's in the early stages. And then Douglas came into the game and started to move things from three-point range. So both Faust and Douglas have contributed all those bench points. As we look at the highlights of the first half, a lot of white, not a lot of blue in this one, I suspect. There's one of the few moves that will catch the editor's eye. Look at that. Not giving up on any of those 50-50s, even though it was right off the ring on the 24-second shot clock. What can we expect in the second? Home side, and the home fans will be hoping more of the same, because the Israelis have got their noses in front, still looking for their first win since they qualify for this competition. Maybe game week five is when it's going to happen. From Faust, as soon as he got involved in the play, that was followed by a three pretty soon afterwards. Here comes that, no, not quite, but we'll see the three, I'm sure, from Faust. There's the rejection, yeah, that's right. Straight after the two came the rejection. And I think we'll see the three from Faust fairly soon. Here he comes, right on cue. Smile on the face, enjoying himself out there, as indeed was Gates with back-to-back twos. So the Douglas back-to-back threes. And at half-time, Israelis have the advantage, 38 points to 31 on the first quarter, on the second quarter as well. Maybe, just maybe, they're on their way to their first victory in the competition proper in 2016. We'll find out in about 10 minutes. So 90 seconds to go till the restart. Welcome back to Nahariya. And well, maybe tonight is the night. Getting close. It's quite warm in here. Oh, she's anything to go by anyway. As we get ready for third quarter to come. And yeah, 7-point advantage for Roni Nahariya. So far, them and the Bracken Bears don't have wins, but both of them are leading at half-time in their respective matches tonight. Helios Suns, who got off the mark last week, played really well against Monaco, but have they got what it takes tonight to find the impetus to stop Nahariya? Got within two, and then Nahariya pulled away again. Gates has been good, but Faust has been outstanding tonight. One great rejection, fantastic two, one spectacular three. And to which Douglas has come in with 2 3-pointers. His first two weren't successful, the next two were. So he's gone to 8 points personal. There's been here before. As we get the third quarter underway, you've just joined us. Helios Suns are in the blue and orange, playing from left to right, and there's the first two of the third quarter. An important two for Tomasz Bocina, their big rebound man in the competition so far. Coming into this game, he had 32 of them. And there's the steal already. They come out of the locker room maybe better. Well, I was about to say that, but an attempt thrown away. Just too quick. Here's the opening two anyway from Bolsina. 5-point advantage. There's the turnover situation. And that two's not going to drop for Gilbert Brown of Nahariya. So still on what they were at half-time. There's a foul. Foul on Gilbert Brown. Oldest of the Americans from Pennsylvania originally, 29 years of age. There's a pick in the pocket too for Helios, who suddenly have trimmed that lead down to three. Waiting for the first 2 points on the home side to get them going in the third quarter. Something good, but they're being kept away from the danger zone pretty well at this stage. And the shot clock down to seven. Have to force it back out, maybe for Douglas. Pops it up for two. Been scoring threes until recently, but there's two more for Stuart Douglas. And he joins the double figure club, joins Gates on 10. And he's back up to five. Brandon Curry will go all the way himself and gets fouled in the act of shooting. Doesn't get the two, but will get two from the line. Foul will be on the basket at the other end. Free throws have been better from Helios. They haven't as many of them, however. And, the Poznan in the Poznan in Israel. 3 points the difference. Easing into that lead are Helios. 37, backing in. No way for Gates. No way for the quality shot from Gates either. They did a good job there, smothering him out. Lelic. Casey. Trying to arrange the players in the right position. And Brown's taking a bit of a knock. I think he's okay. Yeah, he's back up on his feet, making his way rather gingerly back up the court. Here comes the three-point attempt. That's way short. It falls into the hands of Kishlink. Kishlink will just wait to see who can help him out on this offense here. Unless he makes his way more central. He'll come back out for the three, or is it the two? Doesn't matter, because it didn't drop anyway. Kitchen will look to try and get things moving a bit more quickly this time. There's the foul. Yancy Gates in the act of shooting. And Bolshina, is that three for him now? So confirmation of that. I think it might be three. Now, Etty Gates. 10 points personal. Couple of assists, couple of free throws would be nice too now for him. There's the first of them. They needed right at this stage. Two from two from the free throw range. Schlink, Curry, that's the Helios son, so he kept at that end of the court for a little bit longer than maybe they would have liked. KC will make his way to the hoop. Here's Curry. Curry shows, doesn't go. KC still has no real proper look at the basket. And that's 3-0 really for Curry. We'll be back with the home side. And the qualities of shots, the quality of shot selection, not so good from Helios tonight. A big crowd, they are making a lot of noise. They really are. They're encouraging their team and thinking their team might be able to break their duck tonight. Still a way to go yet before they start thinking that, really. Up it goes for three, another one. And it's the same man again. Three threes now for Stuart Douglas. From that kind of range, he's been absolutely on top form tonight. 7-point advantage. Ooh, yes, that is a foul. And he knew it as soon as he committed it, Gilbert Brown. Well, he may give the impression of somebody who doesn't know he's just fouled. But he knew full well. Just caught him on the way through. Probably wasn't intentional, but it doesn't matter. Intent is not the call. Curry. Casey. These two play together at Harvard, so they'll know each other very well. That's again going to fall to nobody. Came off blue last, not white. But Brown's still thinking about that foul. He's on three. Derwin Kitchen. Lindsay Gates. Just take his time. Look at that, rather loping his way to the hoop. Doesn't drop either. He's done all the hard work, but didn't complete the job. As Curry at the other end probably will. No, he won't, because he's smothered out of it. Brilliantly by Gates, who got involved again. This time at the other end of the court. They'll look for three-point play maybe from Gates. Gates looking left, looking right. Wants somebody to move into the key, and nobody's quite there yet. Kitchen, time running out on the shot clock. Needs something coming fairly soon, you think, into the fives. And there's the two. Nicely done. Backdoor pass for Gates to Kitchen. And timeout has been called. Lovely work by Gates. They left it quite late, but Kitchen was there right on time. Kitchen goes to five. And the lead is seven.
Next offense, three with a screen, stay over here. that new screen from the five.
Let's go. Yeah, so they were seventh. Lead actually is nine. Aggressive. 46-37. So, haven't had a double figure lead yet. Look at that, Stuart Douglas. See three pointers now. Halfway through the third quarter. You won't be thinking about that win just yet because there's still loads and loads and loads of time yet. But they are much closer than they were. Curry back out for the three-point attempt. Well, they're not as close now because that's trimmed the lead sufficiently. Carl Casey finding his range from 3 points. Territory. Now, Gates for the home team. Again, almost double team. There were two blue shirts running in the way. Derwin Kitchens having to go very, very deep, then go baseline. They have to throw it back out for a long two. Needs the shot. It's dropped. Oh, it dribbled in. It just dribbled in. They're going to check that. Douglas it is. Got the shot away now. Did it touch the ring before the zero? That's what they're saying. That's the three-pointer at the other end. But they've given it. He's overly pleased by that. 8 points, the advantage. Gates. Kitchen. For a bit of a slide there off the back of that shot. But he's allowed to miss one occasionally. And there's the steal. And there's going to be the intentional foul. So here comes the shot. And obviously, sideline possession. Nick Faust it is. He got the two. He's going to get the extra one. And there's the intentional unsportsmanlike on Carl Casey. Two personal fouls. Extra point for Derwin Kitchen. On the five now with that two. Bounce back in. Just now what they're checking here. Right, yeah, it was Faust who got the two. Not quite sure what the yeah, it was, so it should be Faust going for the free throw, shouldn't it? Yeah, there's the unsportsmanlike intentional foul by Carl Casey. So it is going to be Faust going to the line. You can't do it like that, though. Doesn't count. Nice if it did, though, wouldn't it? Right, so we'll get this, and then they'll go. They'll get possession back on halfway. Great from free throw range, but for everything else he's been pretty good tonight. Kitchen goes on a bit of a charge into the corner, wants the ball delivered to him early, wasn't delivered to him early enough, so he's going to have to work his way inside again. Oh, just as I was talking him up, Faust loses it, but then they get it back again. They're working so hard for each other right now. Faust then throws it away, and it'll be back court if he touches it. Let's go on a play, probably wise. Just a bit of a scrappy bit of play there after Faust has done so well. He's still on 9 points. Gates is on 12. Douglas is on 14, leading all scorers now. Ratech. His link. Just not. That's full rotation really, is there? But that's okay because they get the two on this occasion, but just a little bit static. Carl Casey. Dylan Kitchen. Lead down to six again. Faust. Bounce pass inside for Tyrone Nash. Fizzing around, isn't it? But they're not fizzing it into the basket where they want it to go. It's with Lelic. Up for no points. And we'll come back out to Douglas again. 48-42. Kitchen works his way into the paint. Nice work. Lovely little finger roll by Yancey Gates. And they hit the 50 mark. 8-point lead. 14 personal now for Yancey Gates. 6 from 13 from the floor. There's the foul from Derwin Kitchen. This is what he did at the other end to open up those Yancey Gates. Back into the play. Jonathan Schildebrand. As the game goes, Dodi Lelic on the other side. Brandon Curry will put the ball in bounds eventually. River Coon is on four fouls. Needs to be careful here for foul out. Oh, nice. Behind the back pass. And two, three. That's the three-pointer. Just stepping back outside from Bratic. Well, three-pointers have been very much at a premium for Helios Suns, but that's one that does count. Douglas knows where the three-point range is to go. Short for two, that's going to be rejected, and there's the foul, which is committed by whom? That's committed by Remakun. He's out of the game. I think the foul actually is on Carl Casey, so I think he's all right. Remakun at the other end. Coon's on four, but I think the foul's on Casey it is. Nash, oh, those free throws. Not good. Not good at all. And if it's tight, that's what's really going to hurt them. It is tight. It's only 5 points. This could be six if this goes through, which it doesn't. Doesn't get close. Free throws, 7 for 17. They've missed 10. Lead would be much, much more impressive if they put a smidgen at those away. Okay, see, there's the foul. Looks like butter would melt Jonathan Schildebrand, but that will be a foul, and that will bring play to a halt. And we'll try and get Aaron Asante-Asari back in. As Douglas checks out. Checking out with 14 points. Fischlenk. This is the first. Gets the second. These is four. Asante-Asari. Come back out. Ooh, we thought about the three, but decides to go for the two short instead. Leaning over, and happy Kevin didn't foul there as well. So ran 4 points so far. Oh, that's a good interception, but he just stepped out of bounds. Did Niv Berkovits. Good interception, but just look, his foot goes just out of bounds. Very tight call, but it was the right call. Curry, going a long way around, gets fouled. Foul on the way to the hoop, on the way to the basket. And, 120 remaining. Foul on Tyrone Nash. We go to the line for two. That Unlucky the other end. These ones are dropping. 3-point gap now. Brandon Curry goes to 12 with that. Lead comes back to 2. Smallest lead it's been for some considerable time for the home team. Just getting the nerves, just getting the jitters, not able to protect what was a game-high 9-point lead on 2 occasions for them. And that nearly slipped away from Tyrone Nash. 3-point attempt in, out. Doesn't drop. Time, maybe, to take stock. Maybe time for a timeout. Could this be the lead? Ooh, thought about it. And last touch comes off a Helios Suns player, just to give a little bit of respite to Irone Nauria. Gotta be timeout time, surely, yeah. Talk this over. Maybe it's just going to be a substitution. I think we might want to have a word or two, but it's relying on their own street smarts and game smarts to work it out for themselves. But so that 9-point lead is now just 2. Berkovits trying to pick the pocket. Is that going to drop? No, it's not. Seconds, so we've got see, it's a 4-second differential on the shot to game clock. They'll take all the time they can on this, which is now 9. Curry, this will tie the game. Eventually, we'll put them in front with that 3-point attempt, but it doesn't. Need to get going here. Asante Asare hasn't got very long. Here comes the 2-pointer, the jam for 2 from Yancey Gates, right on the buzzer. That's given them a little bit more comfort, a little bit more breathing space. It's not a lot, mind you. From a 9-point lead, it's now 4 going into this short break. 52-48. But so the Israelis have won all 3 quarters so far. In fact, that one was won by Helios. That's it from the coaches. Oh, you see the marked contrast in the free throws, can't you? Only missed 2 of Helios. Nauria missed the majority of theirs. Assists looking good, rebounds looking great, offensive rebounds looking brilliant. All of the left-hand column. Nauria steals. Look at those bench points. 39 out of 52 points for Nauria. They come from the bench. Starting 5 didn't contribute a great deal, but you get the 6, 7, 8, 9. They've been doing the job. Doing the job big time as well, but this is where things just fell apart last week. Now, can they keep some kind of momentum going? They lost a little bit in the quarter 3 there. The Suns looking for back-to-back wins. Nauria looking for their first in the competition proper after winning their 2 qualifying matches for the Basketball Champions League. And they are 10 minutes away from getting their first. Their coach will be nervous. His assistants will be nervous. We've got to watch the fouls. They're too badly off in the foul count. Ball in play from Asante Asare. Berkovits. There's a foul happening underneath the hoop from... Now, who was that right under the hoop? She's not happy. We have a lot of shoe leather. They're off again. And that's not in. It's going to fall behind the back of the backboard. And that means an automatic turnover for the away side. Wasn't a quality shot, was it, in the end? Shot selection is going to be crucial. It's going to be key now. Harry, 3-pointer. He went behind the backboard as well, but not this time. Faust Back into the game again. Yancy Gates. Gates gets fouled. Foul is whistled by Sheena. Now that's going to be four, isn't it? Two very quickly before. They got third. I think that's four for him now as Brown re-enters the game. That's only three for Paul Sheena. Bits. Inside for two. Now, committed under the hoop. Small on Gilbert Brown's face. He had a face of thunder when he checked out the game last time. Enjoying himself, having a good night. And that doesn't arrive on the court. Point ball game. Need the ball in play. Find it in play. Brown. Faust. Well, that's a great three-pointer. Might be looking to do something similar here if they come back out. But that one dribbles its way in from Yancy Gates. The ring on both sides. And went in. And that takes him to 18 points personal. And the lead back up to six. And mark it up as tightly as they dare at this stage. Sheena. Bit of again, Faust gets it. He's putting himself here, there, and virtually everywhere today. One end of the court setting up the play, other end of the court denying the play, making the rejection. Shot clock on five. Zilkovic, nope. Seen much of him in the game so far, but there's two very important ones put away. Gates has been their star turn tonight in terms of points. 74 before tonight, and that will take him to 94 for the campaign. That's in seven games, of course, so they play those two qualifying games, but he's getting up towards 100 points in this competition now. Mischlink. Bit of indecision. Two on one break. Easy one. Nice slam. Been waiting to do that all night, Faust. And this time, with nobody very close to him, takes his tally to 11. And that lead creeping back up again to 8 points. Kuchlenk. Up it comes. Out it comes. At the moment, all the momentum back again with the Israeli side looking good once again. Santesari getting second and third phase possession as well. Key. Gates nearly steps out of bounds but just stays in play. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Brown is going to go through a whole crowd of bodies. Not going to drop this time, but they get it back. Brilliant play. That's working hard for the cause. Oh, didn't drop. Just needed that to really put the icing on the cake from Faust, but wasn't able to just put the finishing touches to that one. Back out for Kuchlenk for two. Lead six. 6:45 remaining in the game. And that's an intentional. That's unsportsmanlike. And that means they're going to go to the line the other end. And of course, there's the possession going to be right back in the hands of the Helios Suns. The potential unsportsmanlike on Gilbert Brown. Doesn't agree. Too late now. Decision's been made. So that'll be Helios Suns from the line with Antonakovic. They've done the right job and a good job on free throws tonight. Marked contrast. Maria thrown away so many opportunities from the bonus. And ultimately, if they go on to lose this, it'll be the main stat I think they'll look back on, because everything else has been pretty much in the credit column. Brandon Curry. Ooh, just slipped out of Aslakovic's hands. And Maria. Possession back. Those turnovers. 13 Helios, 8 the home side. Santiasari. Faust. Nash. Their main scorers on tonight, pretty much all out there. Douglas. Look for something. Only 5 seconds remaining on the shot clock. There's no way through. Gets his own shot back again. Gets fouled and will they get the bonus? Yancy Gates gets the 2, goes to 22 and gets the bonus point as well. Just edges them a little bit further clear. Not a winning lead yet though, with the amount of time in the game, but it's getting there. Just over 6 minutes to go. We'll get the 2 and the 1. Providing he can put the one away, and this has been the problem for him. I'm trying to remember if he's actually got one tonight. Yeah, he's got 2 for 3 actually, isn't he? So he's been the one that's been okay from this range. Nash has got 2 for 5. Faust 2 for 7. Well, it's uncharted territory for the home team. They've not been in this position in the fourth quarter before. And that's going to fall in for Kuchlenk. And 5 points separates the two teams now. Kuchlenk goes to 13 points personal. Eccles having to do a lot of work to try and find some room to get a pass away. Backing off and backing off and backing off and get it to put it back in play with 13 to go on the shot clock. If he can find somebody, this needs to be quick. Here he is again. Now, is he thinking about the 3? Or is he going to go inside for 2? That's your answer. The hook shot doesn't drop. And the Blues will come away with it. They'll try and come away with it quickly here. Bit of good, quick transition from Curry, and it's effective as well. Takes them to a 3-point disadvantage, and the coaches are going to want to talk this one over. As Curry drives to great purpose, great effect, gets the shot away. Really powerful stuff as well. Curry's trying to back off there so he didn't draw the foul. Coaches, what have you got to say with just under 6 to go? Tight, it's getting tense, and little mistakes creeping in on both sides, but keep going back to those free throws. That if they put those away, they would have had 10 more points, and this game could be almost out of sight. As it is, it's only 3, and we have 5:21 remaining in the game, and it's possession for Nairia, who are being held for a little bit down that end of the court. Obviously we're over halfway before we've got 16 seconds. Nash will wait and it's a Kitchen. Kitchen needs to make something happen here because there's not too many options. Might have to do this all by himself. He is going to do it by himself, and is effective in doing so as well. That was really his only option too. He looked around and thought, well, nobody's going to help me out here, and I can't get a pass away in time. Got to go for it myself. And that was the best policy in the end. Extends that lead to 6 points. Lelic back into the game. Curry goes for the long two and then goes baseline instead. And Oshina is fouled by Douglas. That's by Douglas. That's by Kitchen. Let's have a look. On baseline. Well, there's the foul. Well, he only had that option. There was nobody else in range, so he had to go for it. Sheena, his one doesn't go through the hoop, comes around and comes back out straight to him. Just to trim it to 5. They've got 2 in the game so far as well. Field goals have not been good, free throws have not been good from his point of view, and that wasn't very good at all. Kitchen with Gates. The crossover. Gates goes baseline. They're going to go for the option of going for the Tyrone Nash shot. That doesn't drop. Kishlink going to go all the way. No, he's going to put it back out for the 3. And it's a slight rebound, slight ricochet on that on the way through. And clock stops at 4:02 to go. Sure, well, there was a slight touch on that on the way through to the hoop, might have slightly derailed it a bit, but 14 seconds on the shot clock. Casey will put the ball inbound for Curry. Kishlink up for no points, and the rebound drops obligingly for Asante Asari. They might just take a little bit of time over this one. Kitchen. Gates up for no points. Marcy's just not dropping at either end at the moment. Curry thinks, puts it back out for the drive to the hoop for nothing again. Amazingly, everybody's missing out on their layups right now. 2 points goes a begging too. Kitchen nearly into the last 3. Kitchen got to be a breaking the non-scoring play here. Surely no, that one doesn't drop either. We've got a long way since that score clicked over to 64-58. Plays almost a minute without any addition, probably a bit more than a minute now. Curry will change that. No, he won't. Asante Asari. Sure, it's going to happen now with Tyrone Nash, who gets fouled. 23 to Gates, 11 to Faust, 14 to Douglas. The individual scorers for the home side. Lead is 6. Not a comfortable lead, even with 2:49 remaining in the game, but they're getting closer. Tyrone Nash, 2 for 5 so far. Key points here. Yes. Makes the lead a little bit more manageable from their point of view in terms of trying to hold on to it. 7 points the advantage, 8 if this goes in. Again, way short. Derwin Kitchen. Timeout has been called. Both coaches probably going to impart their final words in this game. And at the moment, it's going the way for the first time in this competition of the Israelis. And they won't have it done and dusted just yet. Not a big enough lead for that. Let's see what their coach has to say and see what the opposite number has to say too.
1-2. Defense 2. Open. Play through with emotion. Casey, pick and pop. Volley. on the opposite side. All the dribbler, opposite side, player on the elbow, you will be on the level, Lela in the corner. At the moment of pick, back screen, player, take that shot. Penetration, pass in the corner, whatever.
Motion side, motion side special.
Motion side special, yeah. Pick and pop on the side, back screen for the shooter, and attack them. After that, stay in the man-to-man. Let's go.
Casey top scorer for Helios, 17, 14 for Curry, and 13 for Kischlink. And they're three in double figures. But Gates leading all scorers by quite some way on 23. Still 3 minutes to go. We're going to get the rebound here. Doing his crust because what they've just talked about, they're not enforcing on the court. They've got the ball back. Got another 24 seconds to try and do something with it. Curry again looking around, thinking this might be all about me again, and throws it away, but they get it back through Casey, and then he gives it away. Really sloppy from Helios after their win last week. Kitchen. 7-point lead, he can slow things down. He can take as much of the 24-second shot clock as he wants, as long as they get the basket at the end of it to make sure, and they don't, but they're going to get the ball back off the ring for Schulderbrand. Douglas. Schulderbrand, rebound to the men in blue, and that's going to be a foul. Intentional this time. 48. Oh, it's still incredibly tight. Still too difficult to call. Kitchen is his third foul. 8 points personal. Bounced into the game. Curry. Thinking about the three. Goes right the way through for the two. Here comes the three-point attempt. That's too long. But they get it back again. Then they lose it again. Now there's a double team, and that's going to be a foul. And Nick Bowes has put himself around so much in this game. Look at that. Just wasn't going to be beaten on that one. So we're nearly there. 131. He's not happy. I think the calls have been pretty even-handed tonight, to be honest, but Bounce will go to the line. That's better. 2-7 before that. 3-8 now. Now, are they there? Still 90 seconds. Once the play comes back into action again off this. But that's 2-2 when he needed it most. Biggest lead of the game twice has been 9. Make that 3 times, because now 9 points with 91 seconds to go. Here comes the timeout. A lot to do for Helios Sun to get back-to-back wins here. Not so much for Ironi Nauria. They are within sight. 9 in front.
Stay higher. Don't stay low on the low post. Stay on the middle post or even higher. Okay. Okay. Lelic, first move. Go over there, looking for the pass after player. After that, back speed for Casey and looking cut in the corner. So. Back screen for Casey, low pass or shot from the corner. Okay. Stay over there, be aggressive, go on double team play, 14 in the defense.
Well, you've seen plenty of games where 9 points is retrieved in 90 seconds, but it's going to take a lot. Curry needs something quickly here. They haven't got time to play around. not a quality shot by any means, falling away. He's got in a better range there, surely, for the two-point play. There's the foul. Have to stop the clock. Well, some smiles on the face. I think there's a lot of relief that they haven't thrown it away this time when they were in such a good position 7 days ago. Looking to give themselves a 10-point lead for the first time in the game. Never had a double-digit lead. But Santi Asari has a chance to do that here. And does. 1:22 remaining. They've got to reclaim a 10-point disadvantage. It's possible they need something here. And that's going to be two from the line. Faust to another foul. Well, so if both these go in, of course, it's an 8-point ball game with a minute 13 remaining. Sheena checks out. Nadic on the free throw line for two. First of them. Breath, one for two, won't do. And there's the foul, they have got to stop the clock. Yancey Gates is fouled. And we'll go to the other end of the court for two free throws. He doesn't look over enamored by what he's seeing, but I'm sure that Dad will explain it to him later. I think he knows the game is virtually up. One of these two goes down, it probably is. Nancy Gates, 8 rebounds, 23 points tonight. Make that 24. Make that lead 10. Oh dear. Just too much for him. Again, Dan will have to explain. He actually missed his team winning for the first time in the competition proper. He goes on like this. Oh, if he can get this in, it will be the biggest lead there has been in the game. 11 points. Nope. I'm not going to see an 11-point advantage. We're going to see a 12-point advantage. Pop back in by Faust. They can start to celebrate. They can do the Poznan. Do what they want, really, I suppose, at this stage, because the game is as good as one. Terrific stuff. 15 points, Faust. He's had a terrific game. Lelic needs something quickly. Hasn't got time. He's triple-teamed. Hit with three players between him and the hoop, and there was no way he was going to get through from there. Faust, yes, 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 yes. Just brilliant. He's had a couple of really magical moments in this game. There's another. 18 points, personal. Lead now stretched to 15. And Helios are not going to get back-to-back wins. Well, they can celebrate a very good victory. Not even a tight one in the end. Not even close. They got it back to 2 points. Did Helios? Their Suns were 2 points away and had a chance to level the game as well, but didn't do that. And there's a celebration and a half from Faust, who knows the game is, well, surely we can say one now, can't we? With 29 seconds to go and 14-point lead. Casey will go for another one. And on the other end, they're not even defending the basket. Try to slam dunk. That'll go back in, though, from the man of the moment. Bounce goes to 20. Two players in 20 range. That'll drop back to him again, and he'll think about bringing it away, maybe just think about holding on to it. Thought about throwing it away in the end, sadly. 24 from Gates. 20 from Faust, 14 from Douglas, the leading scorers for the home side. 15-point advantage for Nauria. Four games, nothing to show for it, but this one, is going to be a sizable win. 15 points by the looks of things, unless there's another basket before we close, but I don't think there will be. They'll hold on to it, and that's a terrific performance. 18-12 first quarter, 20-19 second quarter. Then Helios just looked like they might make a game of it. 17-14 third quarter, but Irani Nahariya, first win proper. They won their two qualifying games to get here. 4 weeks where nothing quite went their way. Game number five is a sizable victory for the Israelis. 76-61, 24 from Gates. Free throws, we'll forget about that now. Only 50% from bonus territory. They got most of the 3 points, five of them. Dublin's got three of those. Field goals, well, sometimes the stats can lie, 44-33, but pretty much everything else, assists, rebounds, offensive rebounds, massively on top. And, plenty of photos being taken tonight. They can rejoice because they are well and truly off the bottom of the table. Bench points, 58 out of 76. Now, I don't remember seeing that too often, if at all. 58 out of 76 points from the bench. And there's a man who provided 20 of them. Gates with 24, Douglas with 14. Casey leading the Helios scorers with 19, Curry with 14. But in the end, certainly that third quarter where they really showed their mettle. Other than that, a very, very good win for Irani Nahariya. And gives them hope they could just start to catch up. Gates 24 and 8 rebounds. Casey 19 points and 9 rebounds for Helios, who were second best overall tonight. No back-to-back wins for the Slovenians, but a big, big win for the Israelis.